Dada, last time you had told me the examples related to number of pages in a book and time required to read them using inverse and direct variation. I have understood them quite well. What are we going to do today?
Okay. Today we are going to solve examples related to time, distance, speed and work. You find them difficult, right? Yeah. But before that, let us solve one example. You know there is a shopkeeper near our house, right? He used a trick to improve his sales. If you buy 2 packets of glucose biscuits, then he gives 3 chocolates free. And if you buy a packet of cream biscuits, then he gives 2 chocolates free. When I had gone to his shop to buy something, he was counting how many packets he had sold on that day. He told me that in that whole day, he had sold 60 packets of glucose biscuits and 140 chocolates were given away. And you know, Dada, because of my idea of giving chocolates free, all customers bought 2 packets of glucose biscuits instead of 1. So not even a single chocolate was sold. All chocolates were given free with biscuits. After he told me this, I immediately told him how many packets of cream biscuits he sold that day. You know, he was very surprised to hear of this. So Sai, can you tell me how I found out the answer?
Let me understand the question. He gave all chocolates free with biscuits. We know the number of packets of glucose biscuits sold. So now we can find out chocolates given free with them. If we subtract this number of chocolates sold, then the remaining chocolates would be given free on cream biscuit packets. From this, we can find out the number of cream biscuit packets sold. Is that correct?
Correct. Now tell me the answer.
Okay, I'll tell. On 2 glucose biscuit packets, 3 chocolates are given free. On 4 packets, 6 chocolates would be given free. That means there is direct variation between glucose biscuit packets and chocolates. So, glucose biscuit packets divided by chocolates, which is equal to 2 divided by 3, should remain constant. In a whole day, 60 packets of glucose biscuits were sold. To find out the free chocolates which were given along with them, we need to solve 60 divided by chocolates, which is equal to 2 by 3. From this, chocolates is equal to 60 into 3 divided by 2, which is equal to 90, can be obtained. So, 90 chocolates were given along with glucose biscuit packets. Total chocolates that were given away are 140. This means that the remaining 50 chocolates were given free along with the cream biscuit packets. Since there is direct variation between cream biscuit packets and chocolates, as well as we can say cream biscuit packets divided by chocolates, which is equal to 1 by 2, will be constant. Since 50 chocolates have been given free on cream biscuit packets, let us solve cream biscuit packets divided by 50, which is equal to 1 by 2. We'll get the answer as cream biscuit packets is equal to 50 divided by 2, which is equal to 25. This means that the shopkeeper sold 25 packets of cream biscuits that day.
Very good, Sai. Now solve this second example, okay? Suppose a boy makes 3 toys of shadow clay in a day. So, how many toys will 3 boys make in 2 days? Tell me.
Oh God, Dada, how to solve this? There are 3 things in this example. Boys, toys and days. All of them are varying.
Look here, Sai. We will think this properly in steps, okay? Tell me first, if one boy makes 2 toys in a day, then how many toys will he make in 2 days?
Oh, this is easy. In one day, 2 toys. That means the amount by which days will increase the toys made will also increase in the same proportion. So there is direct variation between toys and the days taken to make them.
Mm-hmm.
Now, toys divided by days is equal to 2 divided by 1, which is equal to 2. So, when the number of days is 2, we can write toys divided by 2, which is equal to 2. So, we will get the toys 2 into 2, which is equal to 4. So, in 2 days, he will make 4 toys.
Okay. Now tell me, if one boy makes 4 toys in 2 days, then how many toys will 3 boys make in 2 days?
Okay, Dada. Now the number of days is not changing. So the amount by which boys are increasing in the same proportion the work they do, that is, the toys will also increase. Now again, it's a direct variation. So now we will get toys divided by boys, which is equal to 4 divided by 1, which is equal to 4. So for 3 boys, toys divided by 3, which is equal to 4. For this toy, 4 into 3, which is equal to 12, can be achieved. So Dada, in 2 days, 3 boys will make 12 toys.
Very good, Say. Do you realize that you solved the whole example? We divided it into proper steps, and as you solved each step, at the end you were able to solve the entire example, isn't it?
Yes, Dada. As I thought, in different steps, the example became very easy.
Mm-hmm.
We started from one boy and toys made by him in a day to get toys that he can make in 2 days. And using it, we found out the number of toys made by 3 boys in 2 days.
Correct. Now solve this. If one boy makes 5 toys in 2 days, then in how many days will 4 boys make 30 toys?
There are 3 things in this example too, and they all are varying, like previous one. Let me try to solve it in steps. One boy makes 5 toys in 2 days, and now we have to find out the number of days required by 4 boys to make 30 toys. Let us first find out how many days will one boy require to make 30 toys. In the same amount that the days will increase, so too the number of toys will increase, which is equal to 5 by 2. Now, if one boy has to make 30 toys, then 30 divided by days, which is equal to 5 divided by 2. That is 30 into 2, which is equal to 5 into days. So from this, days is equal to 30 into 2 divided by 5, which is equal to 12, will be the answer. Now one boy takes 12 days to make 30 toys. So let us solve how many days will 4 boys require to make 30 toys. Then we'll get the answer. Toys to be made are the same, but the number of boys has increased. So work will be done faster and in lesser number of days. So there is inverse variation between the days required to make the toys and the number of boys. So their multiplication would be constant. One boy takes 12 days. So days into boys, which is equal to 12 into 1, which is equal to 12. Now for 4 boys, days into 4, which is equal to 12. From this we get days is equal to 12 divided by 4, which is equal to 3.
Okay.
So, 4 boys will require 3 days to complete 30 toys. Did I solve it correctly, Dada?
That is absolutely correct, Sai. You have considered all these steps while solving the examples by properly using inverse and direct variation. So now you have understood it correctly, right?
Yes, Dada. I have understood it very nicely.
Very nice. And you know, Sai, in this example, the toys made is work done, The days required to complete the work is time taken, and the time taken for one boy to complete the work in a day is the speed of doing the work. Try and understand it this way, so you will not find the examples of work, speed and time difficult.
Yes, Dada.
Okay. So now friends, you try and solve this example. If three boys make 5 toys in 2 days, then how many boys are required to make 10 toys in 3 days? Try and solve this. Thank you.